Jose Berríos gets the nod here at home for the American League wildcard game. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matt, thanks. Coming on, Jose Berríos, and this guy has all the tools to be a great one. Great velocity with life, 94 to 97 miles an hour. Power slider, and it's a big sweeper. His changeup is getting better. If this guy brings all three pitches one of these days, he has the potential to throw a no-hitter.
Good night for baseball. 69 degrees here at first pitch. And a full count to George Springer. It's 3-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Now Springer belts one, carrying well out to left. Back goes Rosario. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo home run here off the bat of George Springer, and the Astros take a 1-0 lead.
I thought the leadoff hitter is supposed to set the table for the guys behind them. Not the case with that swing at a bat right now. Game's changed, fellas. Get ready for a good one.
Up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve. Lifetime against Jose Berríos. He's a 333 hitter. Line drive. That's a base hit into the right center field gap.
No mistake what he was sitting on. Fastball, middle of the plate, kept his hands back, stayed through the baseball, and delivers a hard hit line drive.
To the plate now, Michael Brantley. A ball and two strikes now. And there are the umpires assigned to this one. Calling balls and strikes is Mr. Mike Fillmore.
Hey, D-Roll, Mike Fillmore, one of the most consistent umpires throughout the league. Both pitchers and position players love this guy.
Yeah, I think one of the best in the business. How I judge a good teammate is every day he opens that door. Is he consistent? Can I count on him? Mike Fillmore is the exact same way behind the dish.
So he gets the swinging strikeout on the changeup. Michael Brantley becomes the first out of the inning. Plate now, Alex Bregman, and he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Altuve leads off first with one away. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
So now to the plate, Kyle Tucker. Pitch misses low. The throw down. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down. 2-2. Here it is. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now. 3-2.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of getting in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Here comes the payoff pitch, and that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Well, it's obvious that earlier home run he gave up is still on his mind. He had him 3-2, but he didn't want to give him anything over the heart of the plate to hit, so we'll see if that walk comes back to hurt him.
Stepping up to the plate, Yuli Gurriel, and Houston looking for more here in just the opening frame of the game. The set and the 2-1. Bat explodes as this has popped up. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. Astros off and running on the solo homer. On to the bottom of the first. It's now 1-0 Houston. Framber Valdez is on the mound for the visiting squad in this AL wildcard matchup. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
So that'll bring in Byron Buxton. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Yep, that ball went out.
Swing and a miss, 2-2 now. Josh James comes in unexpectedly from the pen in relief of his injured teammate. This is popped up. Therefore, it is Gurriel, and there's one gone. So one away here with the bases empty, and here's Donaldson. Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. James is a guy known for his lights out stuff. He tends to rack up strikeout numbers at a very high rate. However, he does at times get wild. Walks have come back to bite him on more than one occasion.
You know, it's not uncommon, Matty V, for a relief pitcher to come in with really good stuff. And it seems like he's either really hit and miss. He'll rack up a lot of strikeouts, but if he's not quite on, he'll also rack up a lot of base on balls, and that can cause a pitch.
And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow.
Great jump on that ball hit to the gap in right center field. A great diving catch. One of the better plays you'll see.
Here's Nelson Cruz now. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Two-two pitch is fouled away. Two out, nobody on. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They trail this one 1-0. Next up for the Stros, Carlos Correa, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Full count, three balls and two strikes.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
And that misses for ball four, so it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. Could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
Into the box now, Josh Reddick. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Nobody out, runner on first. can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Oh, double play ball to second. 4-6-3, and they turn the double play.
Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the two ball.
So base is empty now after the double play. And next to hit is the catcher, Martin Maldonado. Line towards center field. A dive, but it's off his glove.
That's what we refer to in the biz as a hanger right there. He's lucky he's getting his baseball back.
Into the box, George Springer, 2-1.
One pitch shy of 40 for him right now, and he's not even out of the second inning of work. He's definitely not being as efficient on the mound as he'd like.
Two out with the man at first. Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with a man in scoring position.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and, of course, here in inning number two. Grounded up the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Two down, runners at first and second. In the dirt here. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. The set, and the 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Rosario is there, and the inning is over. Couple of walks, but no damage. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Leading off the inning, Eddie Rosario, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. Now the 3-2 pitch. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
Into the box now, Miguel Sano. 2-2.
Your eyes light up from the offensive side playing in a hitter's park like this. Have to get the ball up to do some damage. I'm not mad at that take.
Hit to short. Fielded cleanly. In time to first, and there are two away. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. They'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Down go the Twins in order. They're down 1-0. Welcome back to Arlington. Before we get much further, let's check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros' offense with Houston's manager. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together.
They've already worked out 3 walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Here's Michael Brantley as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number 3. And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. A runner at first with no outs here. Ball 3.
Got to find a way to get back in his zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a 2-run homer.
Set, here's the 3-1, and he lays off there, ball 4. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
Well, it's obvious he wanted absolutely no part of the 3 or 4 hole hitters, but he's got to focus here because this guy in the 5 hole is just as dangerous.
At the plate, Kyle Tucker. He drew a walk his first time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Shatters the bat as this is hit on the ground. Gonna be a tough play. Gonzalez for 1. Ready for another chance. Yuli Gurriel. Runners are at first and third. 1 away. And he fouls this one off.
With 1 out and runners on the corner, some managers like to hit and run here. It's a little risky, but it can help you stay out of the double play if it's well executed.
A ball and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
In now, Carlos Correa. 2 balls and 2 strikes now. He's set. The 2-2. This is on the ground over to first. And the 2-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. So they let him off the hook here by scoring no runs despite the 2 walks. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number 3. The Astros on top, 1-0. Leading off the inning, Mitch Garver. And they'll need him to get something going here. The 1-1. Hit sharply on the ground. And that's the first hit in this one for Minnesota. Stepping in now, Jorge Polanco. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Nobody out, runner on first. Drives it out to deep right center field. Springer looking up. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. So it's a two-run shot to right center, and the Twins move out on top 2-1.
Man, we've seen that high fastball come into play more and more this year by pitchers, but he tried to sneak a high piece of cheese by this guy. He had no part of it, and he takes him deep.
At the plate now, Marwin Gonzalez. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Now the pitch. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it 4 strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
It's never easy to rebound after serving up a 2-run shot, but that at bat was a good indication to me that he isn't letting it get to him. He went right after him for the strikeout.
So now to the plate, Byron Buxton. And this is swung on and missed, his 5th strikeout already, and there are 2 gone in the inning.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
At the plate, Josh Donaldson. Fouled away. A swing and a miss as he chased with 2 strikes, and that will retire the side. A 2-run score for the Twins, both coming on this 2-run home run. We played 3 full. It's now 2-1 Minnesota. So here's Josh Reddick as we begin the top of the 4th. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. The 1-2. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on first for the out, 3 unassisted. Into the box now, Martin Maldonado. He singled his last time up. And he'll come back with 1 in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Hit out towards second, and that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a 1-out hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came from.
To the plate now, George Springer. And this is taken for a called strike, and he's not in love with that call either. It's 1-2 now. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are 2 down.
That was a good job tying him up inside on that strikeout pitch. It wasn't even in the strike zone, but with the hitter protecting with 2 strikes, that's the kind of pitch you can get him to offer at, and he's probably not going to do much with it when he does make contact.
Standing in now, Jose Altuve. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. And another foul ball. Working for the punch out and the offering. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Drilled on the ground is short. And he'll go the short way to retire the side. 1 left for Houston. They still trail it here 2-1. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Into the box now, Eddie Rosario. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Now the 2-1 pitch is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Of course, there was a fastball.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2. Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. Right side hit hard. And there are two away now. So stepping in, Miguel Sano. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Seared down the first baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ball game, and that one ends the inning. Twins are set down 1-2-3 as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. All set for the start of the inning, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Line toward the alley in left center, but this will be pulled in out there in left center. Well hit, but a rough out number one.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Digging in to try it again, Alex Bregman. It was a walk in his last trip. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The 1-2. Down the left field line and deep. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
This is exactly the reason why this guy has been so successful and has played this game so long, scrambling pitch after pitch, making this guy work out on the mound.
Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Got him swinging, chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You can just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
At the plate now, Kyle Tucker. Three balls and a strike to Houston's left fielder.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
One run, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. hit in the air to straightaway center. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3. They're down 2-1. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Max Kepler. The 1-2.
Listen, I'm not trying to make up an excuse, but this is this guy's fifth inning of work in this game out of the bullpen. Are you kidding me? Nobody goes five innings anymore.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch, and even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Now some action out in the Houston bullpen, as it appears both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. Two runs on two hits and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike.
It's been more than two innings since this guy's allowed anyone to reach base. He looks pretty unbeatable on the bump right now.
And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Into the box, Jorge Polanco. A ball and two strikes to the Twins shortstop. Counts even, 2-2 for Polanco.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ballgame, and this one ends the inning. Down go the Twins in order. They lead it 2-1. So here's Yuli Gurriel. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done.
Off the bat, that had soft base hit written all over it. But a nice snag there by the infielder on that soft liner that could have been a potential base hit.
One away for the Astros here in the sixth. And ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Some movement now in the Minnesota bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. Correa in front, 3-3.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And there's out number two. So striding in, Josh Reddick. Bases are empty here with two men out. Fouled off. Lifted down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. And he misses again, as the command is definitely letting him down now. It's ball four.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Now here comes the Twins manager on his way to the mound. And a change is forthcoming, as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. So he'll depart with the lead and a chance to be the winner, but he is responsible for the tying run at first. Matt Wisler takes over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning. Martin Maldonado will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Down the left field line and deep. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Count remains full. The next 3-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Astros lead one. Our score remains 2-1. Andre Scrub enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Stepping in, Byron Buxton. Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. Two and one now to the Twins leadoff man. Buxton ahead in the count, 3-3. Josh Donaldson will be next. The 3-1 waves and misses for strike number two.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Well, you gotta love a live young arm. He's got an electric fastball, and if he can learn to harness that and work in his solid secondary stuff, he's gonna have a really nice career on the mound. Not everyone is gifted with a fastball like that.
In now, Josh Donaldson. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two. Two out, nobody on. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
And this one misses high for ball four, and they have themselves a two-out base runner. Next will be the designated hitter, Nelson Cruz, 0-for-2 for him to this point. A runner on first with two away. Out of play. Hit hard on the ground to second. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. One left for Minnesota. They still lead it 2-1. George Springer will stand in again as we take you back to earlier in the ballgame. This one swing here has been the entire offense to this point, as this home run accounted for the only run they've tallied so far. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two and two.
Hey, looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Here now the 2-2.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Shot to second base and handled for the first out. At the plate, Jose Altuve is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. Hit in the air down the right field line. And foul. The 1-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Buxton is under this one, and he's got it for out number two. So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. Plate, Michael Brantley. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here's the 1-1.
That's the ball.
Here's a swing, and oh, man! Way out of here! A solo shot here to straightaway right field, as the Astros have bounced back to tie this one at two.
Big time at bat right there. Team trailing, and he ties it up with a bomb. Interested to see how this one finishes out.
To the plate now, Alex Bregman, hit on the ground toward the left. Oh, look at Donaldson. What a play. They call it the hot corner for a reason, and this is a beauty to take us to break. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. And we're back for the bottom of the seventh as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs, so the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Blake Taylor gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And digging in is the outfielder, Eddie Rosario. The 1-1. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Therefore, it is the Gold Glover Reddick, and he's got it one away. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Swing, high drive, left field and deep. Tucker looks up, and they have taken the lead. A solo shot that time for Miguel Sano. And the Twins have taken the lead. It's now 3-2.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
Standing in now, Max Kepler to right field and absolutely hammered. Forget about making a play on that ball. It's way out of here. Back-to-back home runs. A solo shot here to straightaway right field, and it gives the Twins a 4-2 lead. Perez takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs of this seventh frame. Stepping in now, Mitch Garver. Outside, 2-1. Still only one out in the inning. And it's fouled away. He swings and crushes it. Oh my, there is no doubt about this one. And they've done it again. Back to back to back home runs. A solo shot here to left. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball game.
For
Jorge Polanco will stride in, but first we take you back to the third as you take another look here at his two-run homer that had him rolling early on. Sharp ground ball to third. And off, he gives it the old Ole at third, and he gets right by him into left.
You never want to beat a pitcher that breaks a guy out of a slump, but this guy was too good. You knew it was a matter of time before he started barreling baseballs. That gives him a multi-hit game, and I'm sure he's feeling good about it.
Into the box now, Marwin Gonzalez. Pitch swung on and missed the throw. And now two-base tag is there. He's out at second base.
That very well could have been a hit-run play, but that pitch was so far out of the zone, it really made it hard for the hitter to make any contact. Kind of left his teammate hung out to dry.
Here now the 2-2.
Okay.
Wow, fastball up and in. I'm not sure it was intended to be that far up and that far in, but message sent, beware.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. Three runs already home here. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. All even now, 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Making him sweat out there, the seventh pitch coming up. And he misses again, ball four, and that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
Enoli Paredes trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. Three across so far in the inning, and another two out there on base.
Yeah, Matt, and this inning's really starting to get away from them on the defensive side of the ball. Stranding the rest of those guys out here feels absolutely essential for them at this point.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Down the left field line and deep. And no one will get this one. Here now the 2-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. So they get three runs here, all coming via solo home runs. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. It's the Twins 5 and the Astros 2. Trevor May has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th. Ready for another shot now, Kyle Tucker. He flew out in his last at bat. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. the 2-1. A swing, and this ball is blasted to right field. Nothing's going to keep this one in the ballpark. And this one is gone, a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field, and it's a 5-3 game now.
One swing at a bat, he shows you why he's dripping with tools. He's got the speed, he's got the power. You don't know how to attack this guy. You can't put him on base with a knock or a walk, or he'll just end up on second or third. And if you leave something over the heart of the plate, that's what can happen.
At the plate, Yuli Gurriel. Maybe too much break on the slider, 2-1. As we near the end of this one, I think it's safe to say that the story of the game has undoubtedly been the long ball. Guys, what do you think about what we've witnessed?
Well, as a former offensive player, I absolutely love it. Kudos to both lineups for doing absolute damage today. One of the most fun watches of the year.
You know, D-Row, what this shows me is this new age way of guys.
And hold on now. That's a fair ball down the left field line. Should be at least a double. The throw is wild, and it gets away.
Well, he was definitely not looking off speed on that pitch. I'll tell you, he had to be sitting on a fastball on that one because it's coming in hot, and he still manages to get out front of that and yank it for two bases.
So now to the plate, Carlos Correa. One ball and two strikes to count. Two is an off-speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2. And he fouls this one off. No one out with a runner at second. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. Josh Reddick, who represents the possible go-ahead run here, waits in the on-deck circle. 3-2 pitch. Is swung on and missed. He got him.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box, Josh Reddick. And that misses, 2-1.
Watching him on the mound right now, I think he's just having trouble throwing strikes to this guy. Up only two runs, I don't think he's working around him.
Runner at second here with one man out. Fouled away. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. You see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. So two gone now in the Houston eighth, and up next, the former Angel Martin Maldonado. Now the 2-1 pitch is in there for the second strike. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Astros get a run back here on the solo shot. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth. It's the Twins 5 and the Astros 3. bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and standing in is the DH, Nelson Cruz. The 3-1. High in the air out to center field. Springer has a read on it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Standing in, Eddie Rosario. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. The 1-2. High and deep to right center. Back goes Springer to the track. Now a leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run. Solo shot to right center, and it's now 6-3. Miguel Sano. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now. Now the Astros are going to get a left-hander up and cranking out in the bullpen. Hits are even at 7 apiece. Got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you could spot your pitches there in advantage counts like 1-2, you're going to have a lot of strikeouts and soft contact.
At the plate now, Max Kepler. There's ball 2 as the slider dips below the zone.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Back up the middle. That gets through, and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game.
He got the pitch he wanted, and he didn't miss it right there. Hammer job.
Into the box now, Mitch Garver. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. 2 out with the man at first. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Another 1-2 delivery. Line drive to left. Tucker is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. But the Twins add on thanks to this solo shot. Last chance coming up for the Astros. As they've doubled up now, it's 6-3. Taylor Rogers comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Now the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss got him reaching. The throw down to first, one away. Now in the box, Jose Altuve. He's 1-for-4 for the game. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. Kepler's on his horse. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. And their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. And this ball swung on and hit to center field, and this should do it.
Buxton
is there, makes the catch, and the ball game is over.
Wow, talk about a do or die situation. Amazing, they find a way to win the wild card game and advance to the division series. I know the home crowd made a difference cheering them on. Now they have all the momentum going into the next round.